Why, hello, and welcome back, my friends, to another episode of Voice of the Rings. I'm your host and guide, Zollin Ironshield. And today, I'm going to answer a question that many people have asked me in my comments, and by popular demand, I'm going to make the video. What is the best class to solo with in Lord of the Rings Online? Well, this is a very, very good question, but we need to break it down slightly because it's a little too generalized. So, the first thing is, are there classes that are just not good to play solo in Lord of the Rings Online? Well, it kind of comes down to your own personal preferences and how you like to play a game, but I would recommend that most classes actually do have the capability to solo quite well, all right, depending on the trait tree you are using. But so you don't go, we don't make this too long for you, let me go into best description I can give you as well. We'll go through each race and class real quick and tell you what the best one is. Zollin Ironshield is someone I've been playing a long time, but again, it is popular with what you like as well. But I will give you my best I can. And if you do enjoy, don't forget to like and subscribe. It means a lot. And I don't want to, if you're someone who doesn't want to be here for the whole 15-minute video or whatever, I'll give you a quick little information here on the video. All right. So when it comes to classes, all right, we have several classes here, right? Classes is what really you need to worry about. When it comes to race, that's more of personal preference for fun. It will not affect your soloing. We're talking about your abilities as classes, right? So, when it comes to our classes, we have Bjorning, Brawler, Burglar, Captain, Champion, Guardian, Hunter, Loremaster, Minstrel, Runekeeper, Warden. If I was going to give you my top that are really good at being alone and doing content, which is clearing out minions and stuff, it really comes down to, I mean, a lot of melee classes are very good at soloing. I would recommend, you know, champions, guardians, wardens. They're very good at a solo class, very quick to do stuff. I would say that some of the hardest classes to do solo would probably be, off the top of my head, it would probably be the Runekeeper or possibly, you know, the Bjorning or the Captain. But again, you guys, I have to break this down a little bit more. There's going to be different views on this from different people who have played different classes. And honestly, if you want the opinion right off me, of course, I would never lie to you. Really, any class will work in LOTRO. I know, you're like, that's a silly answer for a video that's about this. Well, I'll go into more detail right now. But every class really has a specialized tree that will allow you to do solo content by yourself. Brawlers are very, very powerful, the new class. They're punching. They're going to be great for solo. They have good AoE with some stuff, and they do a lot of damage. They're very tanky. They're very good to do stuff by themselves. Bjornings, maybe a little bit more challenging than other classes, but they're pretty good at taking care of themselves solo. They can heal themselves. They have some decent AoE melee damage, which is air of effect. They're pretty good for that. Burglars are they are very good at soloing to an extent. They're very good at sneaking into a place, getting a kill on something. They don't have a massive amount of area of effect. What I mean is, if you're doing a lot of solo content where you need to kill a lot of mobs, it might take a little longer because you have to, like, target. You will kill things quickly, but they are a lot better at single target damage. They do have some AoE. They're still very good, though, at solo content because you can sneak in and get a boss or sneak in to a place. Again, you can't always sneak in with an instance, but if it's a boss that's out in the open world, pretty easy to get to them and pretty easy to 1v1 something with a burglar. They're kind of designed for tricks and being stealthy, right? Hence the burglar. Captains. Captains are they're a good class. I would definitely say probably for solo content, yes, they're very strong. They can heal themselves. They have a friend, assistant, like a creature NPC that follows them around. They deal pretty decent damage. Again, they can solo by themselves, but they might not be able to clear quite as fast as maybe like a champion could or something. But really, again, it really depends. They can do a lot of damage too if you trait them in the right tree. So they could also solo as well. Again, I know this is kind of like, oh, so you're saying that all classes can solo in Lord of the Rings Online. Well, yeah, that's kind of my answer to a lot of people who ask what's the best solo class. It really comes down to preference of what you like to play. And then you have to think about what they're good at. Champions don't really, again, captains don't have a whole ton of AoE area of effect. They're kind of single target a lot, like the burglar, which is why I kind of think they're more on the line of harder to solo with. Champions don't have a lot of self-heals, but they have a lot of AoE. So they're very good at doing just clearing out mobs and doing stuff solo because they can just blow through it with a sword spinning everywhere, all right? So again, they're a more easy class to use. Again, sometimes it comes down to how hard they are. A captain is class difficulty moderate. Champion and guardians are basic. Now, guardians, their two-handed ability is very nice. You can easily solo with a guardian. They have a lot of defensive abilities. They can have pretty good AoE. So if you're using a two-hander, it's very easy to clear through things. If you're having troubles killing something, take out that shield, you're impossible to kill, take you longer to kill it, but they're still pretty strong. As you've seen in a lot of my videos, they're pretty good at being solo. All right, hunters. Hunters are a little on the harder side to be solo, even though the reason being is because they want to be at ranged, and most mobs, when you pull them, come into melee contact. So as much as they are a basic class to play, they're a little bit more challenging. There are a lot of abilities that let you use abilities on the run, but it kind of interferes with your abilities when you fight a lot of mobs at once. It'll make it a little more challenging. So I would recommend hunters a little harder on the scale, just because the fact that they want to be ranged, they want to not be attacked by things, right? They want to be able to use their inductions. They do have abilities to keep them from being interrupted, and they have abilities to run and back up while they do stuff. So, and they have traps and stuff, so they can definitely solo still. A little bit more challenging though. Now, when it comes to the lore master, lore masters, they have great CC, they have a pet to help them, they have their own heals, they have good damage. So as a mage goes, pretty good at soloing. Again, probably a little bit more challenging than maybe an easier class of a melee. They can just, like a champion, they could just rip through and shred through everything. Because lore masters, you're gonna have to think about, okay, I have to stun all these guys. Now I'm gonna have to cast my lightning ability into my ent move and wipe all these like 10 mobs I just pulled by myself. You could do it, it's really fun. You'll have really crazy burst damage as magical. But again, a little harder than maybe a champion would be in soloing, or maybe a brawler, you know what I mean? Minstrels are healers. A lot of people think, oh, well, can they do solo stuff? Yes, their damage line is very good. They have some decent AoE abilities. They have high single target explosion damage. Like you've seen it in my LOTRO tale, we just two-shot things all the time, creatures. It can be a little bit more challenging taking on multiple foes, but they have abilities to get out of it. So, you know, you can heal yourself on the spot, or you know, use your faint ability or shield ability. There's things you can do with minstrels. Again, I think they're still decent for doing solo content. And once you want to play with other people, then you can heal, and then they'll all love you then too when it's not solo content. But again, decent at solo content. Runekeepers. I would actually say runekeepers, it comes down to two. You have to split it up. This is why this is a hard thing. It's multiple things that can be into it. So runekeepers are very good at doing lightning damage to single targets and running. So in that way, they're good solo. If you have tons and tons of enemy mobs, when they're running and single target, all their AoE abilities, a lot of them, they have to channel and in one spot. So if you take more than three mobs, it's going to be challenging. So runekeepers are more on the hard end of soloing out of everything. They're probably going to be one of the more harder ones. They're probably better at group things where someone's tanking or in your healing or you're doing damage. But again, one target, like a burglar, they're fine. They can kite the target. They have a stun. They can just blow them up with lightning and run away as they do it, right? Just kite them, meaning you're running backwards as you shoot abilities at an enemy trying to get to you. Again, that's one of the reasons, again, why it's harder with hunters. They can also kite with one trait tree they can do, but it makes it harder because people are trying to interrupt them, hit them while they're using their abilities kind of stuff, right? Wardens are a great solo class. They can take multiple mobs just like champions. They can wipe things out. They have good bleeds, good damage. They can heal themselves, buff themselves. Great solo class. So to finish up, to not make the video very long for you, I wanted to make it as short as possible. I would highly recommend good soloing classes if you like the playstyle of a melee character or someone with a spear. I would say a warden is very good. Guardian and redline, champion, very good. I would even say probably the new brawler is pretty good. Middle class solo things that are a little more challenging when it comes to melee and stuff, but still would be good. And lore master, captain, burglar, bjorning, they're kind of middle solo on difficulty with soloing, right? That's what I would put those at. And maybe a minstrel tossed in there, possibly, right? in that one. And then for the hardest ones, I would say to play solo is the Hunter Runekeeper. Just because the fact if you want to pull multiple mobs at once, it's a little bit more challenging since Hunters have actually a little bit better AoE than Runekeepers. And again, some people might disagree with me in saying this. I will also, as a disclaimer, you can easily enjoy soloing with a Hunter and Runekeeper still. It'll just take you a little bit more skill and knowledge how to do it. But again, to answer the long question, what is the best class to solo with? It's kind of not an answer of any one class. Every class is unique in a different way of soloing versus doing it raid or instance. What is your preferred play style? Would you rather use a spear and shield with a javelin? Wardens are great. They can take multiple targets at once. Champions, great, can take multiple targets at once. Burglars and captains, they're going to be more along the line of the better with one target damage, but they're also very strong. They can still solo. Brawlers, same thing. With that kind of area. Bjornings, similar with that. I would still say Bjornings aren't the easiest to solo with because they take a lot more ability to learn just because they're advanced class. So it's a little bit harder when it comes to soloing. Hunters, Minstrels. Minstrels, they don't have a lot of... They have a couple good AoE abilities, so they're rather good because you can kite around where you kill things very easily if you have the right stats and everything built in. With your gear and what you've upgraded with your virtues. Runekeepers, I think it, off the top of my head, if I was going to say what is the hardest class to solo with, I think I might actually say Runekeeper. And that's one of my most played classes just because I've played every class, but just because the fact that they're great at single target. So if you're just killing mobs that are single target out in the field, great. If you go into a base that has tons of mobs, you walk in, it's going to be a lot more challenging with the Runekeeper because you have to clear everything as you go. Where a champion or a warden, you could run and take 20 mobs, kill them all in one go and move on. You're not going to be able to do that as good with this. You could sort of do that with a lore master too, take a bunch of mobs, but you have to do it really smart. You have to have your pet take them all, then throw your big AoE stun, and then use all your stun abilities and lightning and kill them all as fast as you can, because you don't kill them all fast and you're not strong enough, they will swarm you and kill you very quickly in your pet, okay? So... Again, this is why Guardians are also, again, very easy. So I would say the easiest classes to solo with, probably Champion or Guardian, because they're very simplistic, very easy in that way. Warden is a more complex one, but very good at soloing as well. Runekeepers, everyone else you can still solo with. It's just more challenging on Runekeepers and Hunters and Loremasters because they're a little bit more, they're magey. You have to think about your distances. You have to think about your range. That's why. Bjornings and Brawlers are kind of there in the middle. They're just a little bit more challenging because of learning curves. And then Burglar and Captain are also, again, more challenging than Champions and Guardians with learning curve, but they have a lot more single target damage. They're not as much AoE as a Guardian or Champion can put out, right? Again, Runekeepers too. They don't have a lot of AoE that isn't inductions. Inductions are the time bars, right? Well, they load their spell to shoot, and those can be interrupted if you're being hit by mobs or enemy NPCs, right? So that's why you have to think about this stuff. Minstrels are all instant cast things. That's why they're a lot easier to kite around. Hunters have inductions, but you can do them on the run if the right tree you set up. Lore Masters, again, they have a pet to pull everything, but all their stuff are inductions too that can interrupt you. So if you get too many mobs on you and you're not prepared with your pet and with stuns, you can get destroyed very easily. So anyway, I hope that kind of helps you guys out to kind of give you an idea of what you should work on. Think about when you're picking the best solo class. Again, too, do you want to play a melee character? Do you want to play a mage character? Remember, we know who are the mages? The mages are the Lore Master, Minstrel, and Runekeeper. Those are kind of the magical classes in the game. The melee characters that use some kind of physical weapon, Guardians usually use shields or two-handed weapons. Champions usually use dual-wield. Burglars usually dual-wield daggers. Captains usually use a halberd, two-handed halberd. Brawlers have their gloves, their punching gloves. Bjornings use an axe usually or some kind of dual weapons or a weapon, and then they transform into a bear, right? And they do bear attacks. And then wardens use spears and javelins with their shield, all right? Minstrels use their voice and their magical singing and instruments to do damage. Runekeepers use runestones, magical firepower, lightning, ice. And hunters are bow and arrow or a crossbow, right? They are the ranged the ranged physical damage class is the hunter. So anyway, my friends, again, I hope that helps you out. hope that you get a little knowledge out of that for your best, the best solo class. It's a little bit more complicated of a question than is asked a lot. So again, remember the different levels of what I think difficulties are, but it really comes down to you and your knowledge of what class is the most difficult, and do you want to play a character that has a lot of AoE, or you want to be a mage, or whatever. All of them will work solo. Some of them might be a little easier for your own personal preference than others, but all of them in LOTRO can solo. It is possible to solo to an easier degree. Some of them are just a slight, will be more simple than others, like I explained already. All right, you guys, you have a great day in Middle Earth. Again, leave comments. I'd be happy to answer other questions if something you're a little confused on with that, or I'll make another video in the future. But the biggest thing is, just know all classes are soloable. Soloable. Say that. That's a hard word to put together. In LOTRO, I would just recommend there are ones that are slightly better than others. Like the melee classes that have a lot of AoE, champions, guardians. They're also the more basic classes. They're a little easier to solo with when you learn how to use their abilities, but you might prefer someone like a mage with a minstrel lore master, probably the easier mages instead of the runekeeper. Runekeeper takes a little more work to solo with because it's hard with the single target thing. Then again, that's the issue too with the burglar and captain. Very good, they can solo easily by themselves, but they're more for single target soloing. They won't be able to pull a whole camp quite as easily. Yes, they can do it. Captains do have some AoE. Burglars do have some AoE. But it might just be a little bit more challenging. But once you learn it, it won't take you very long. It'll take you a day to learn that kind of stuff and know how to do it on every class once you play each class. About a day on each class, probably, to learn it. All right, you guys have a wonderful day in Middle-earth. I'll see you on the next episode of Voice of the Ring. Subscribe if you've ever earned it. Next guide's up there. And a LOTRO Tale, my main content's over there. You have a great day in Middle-earth, and I'll see you all in the next episode of Voice of the Rings. Baruch Kazad, Kuzad, I menu.